is sound.
The Lord is good.
The Lord is kind.
The Lord is kind.
The Lord is good and that is his nature.
Wow, you look beautiful from here.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. I'm so happy to be in your midst. This, I don't know how we'll call it. It's an associate or a reunion summer. Which is the one?
Reunion.
Reunion, yeah? Reunion, good. Because we have those who are before coming in and joining up with the rest that are there. I want to encourage them and tell them that out there it's still okay. You know, yeah. There's better green pastures for you to feel. Yes, I'm so happy to see all of you looking so beautiful from here. Thank you so much, the wonderful choir. The Kuzda choir, you know? Yeah. We should sing again. Yeah, my sister was back. Yeah, another one. Thank God so much for you. Thank you to the elders for coming, for allowing me to be able to come and administer at this church. Thank you to the associates. All the way, I think, to the answer 2015. See you? Mm-hmm. I think we should do a better work of bringing the associates this place, you know.
Mm.
Hey, we need those ones from 2010, 1990s, you know. Yeah. The 1990s of this place. Why, how long ago is this institution? Yes.
2011.
First graduation was what? 2011.
Mm.
2011, you know.
Yeah,
I can imagine their master in a first. Yeah, we should look for them. And next time we're having an associate Sabbath, it will be more full. This place will be looking for another ground to have such an event. See you?
Mm.
Yes. 2011, 2012, 2013, at least one. Someone should be in charge of doing that work. Taputa. Don't worry. Yeah, it's an associate Sabbath. Associates are the ones that are working. The children are around. Now, in the congregation, I'm delighted that I have followers, you know. I have followers. That, and they make sure I'm a sheep so that they can give me company today. And my and his wife, I'm so happy that you're here. These are my church members back at home. I can see my brother. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm so glad that he's also part of the congregation. By the way, in this position should have been my sister, Whisper. But all in all, she decided that we be those who then she'll speak to us in the afternoon. Amen. So feel at the feet of Jesus. You are such a beautiful congregation, and I pray that the Lord shall minister to us. Amen. And you get the encouragement and the spiritual nourishment that the Lord so desires. So, my name is Pastor Ida Kemonto. Ida Kemonto comes to you from Tasse Central. Tasse Central is in Embakasi District. But we are grateful that we are here and to worship and celebrate with you. Now, many times when I begin my receive pastors' greetings. You receive them. And I buy it also. Thank you. So, we have to start with a song. Song number 100. Great is thy faithfulness. We will be beginning our reunion. Yes, this was. Great is thy faithfulness. And I want you to sing more lively than you were doing before. Papa Mother. We are not here to sleep, we are here to celebrate. The Lord has done us well. Amen?
Amen.
Yes. Great. Let's go.
Great is thy faithfulness, so
no. Just for some few waters
come and just brush down the whole of this thing, and it was none of that. In this life, friends, we build things. In this life, we face certain trials and afflictions that come by in our way. We wrestle them so seriously. And we think that we are climbing up that ladder. Storms come and bring down that castle that we had so tried to lift up high. Some trials come. They look so tragic. They look so dramatic. And when someone comes and tries to compare the situation with you, you almost feel like yours is not to be compared like with even them. They look even less troublesome than theirs. You have looked at your life this far as a student in this institution. Many of the trials that you have gone through, many of the castles that you have tried to build, you yourself. Some trials that come in your life could be inevitable. Like the 7 a.m. classes. I'm a 6:30 a.m. classes. Well, you know, we were coming with my sister, Joy Holden, all the way from that other side to the other place. I'm imagining someone who has classes in this place. I love when we have classes and happy. 6:30. And you have to be here. And I don't know how full your classes could be. And then someone is just speaking from here. Maybe you've come late and you're back there. You cannot even hear. And you struggled to come on the way. You know, you come, you have struggled all your time, and then you unafika class, and then the lecturer does what? Postpones the class. You're like, it was 6:30, man. You couldn't just do that. And that is it. That is it. Amanda, and what do? You have to walk again all the way to that place. Anyway, struggles of being a student. You can imagine the troubles of eating from the mess. In our place, I'm a student at Bugema University in Kampala. And so we have a cafeteria, my goodness. I cannot imagine someone staying in Bugema for 4 years eating from the cafeteria. You know, there, rice and beans is the best meal ever. Chakula ya wadosi. Rice and what? RMB. Chakula ya nini? Wadosi. Bugema is one among the very most expensive institutions in the whole of Kampala. And so when you go there, the parents are like, we have taken you to the best institution. Please go and do your best. And then, you know, sisi tunatoka again and we're like, what are we? Are we going to eat rice and beans, Ugandan beans, every day? And you can imagine all that, living in that institution for 4 years, lunch and supper, beans has to be there. And our Ugandan is very happy. And I was imagining in this place that you are among in the clubs, and though, despite you being among the leaders, yet you cannot involve yourself in their activities because they put them on Sabbath. These are among the things that are inevitable, you being in this place, yet you still have to be a star. You still have to be a student. I know those who pass through here can look and sit and look up and say that, this thing that we did, see, we ate from that cafeteria, from that mess that you did. We walked all this while, but yet it is a milestone for someone who's here. The trials that we face in this place, some of them will be unpredictable. Yet you wake up very early to come to this place, then one day a phone call just rings, and you're told that one of your close relatives has just died. Or even being diagnosed with a very, very traumatic disease. And you're like, wait a minute, I'm just but a student here. What will I do? Who am I to face such a situation? Yet, you be here, and even you lose your sponsor. You know, there are people who are here but are being sponsored fully by someone out there. Maybe your parents are not here, but you're just here hoping and praying seriously for that sponsor to live forever, you know. So that's a funny meaning. They keep on sponsoring you until you finish this place. Then one day, all of a sudden, that person just decides to leave. give you, and you're all in all. You're still a student in this place. Some of these trials that we face, yes, they're all multicolored, all come in different types and shapes and different colors, and they inconvenience us. They inconvenience us in very many ways. Major crises, small crises, different problems. We cannot even tell which kind, which corner they are going to come from. We have assignments to handle, and lecturer Nakunja, you was busy in church the whole day, and tomorrow someone requires of these assignments. You're wondering, how will I tell this person that I was in church? You know, I was busy, I could not. And anyway, school life is hard. You know? Yeah, school life is hard. I can attest to that. School life is hard. Personally, in school, I work in the church. I am serious in church. I'm very serious again in church. Those are different departments I need. I'm still a pastor. And then I have to be at home because I stay in a home. And then I have classwork. And I have to do all those rotations. And still, I'm expected to be the best out of it all. I have to give a first class at the end of it all. You know, someone is all expecting, your parents are giving, have all these expectations from you. And you're here, you have to mingle church and social life and boyfriend and girlfriend here, amekuja, amekudismiss, amekuacha, kesho uko na wewe, another person is coming, and all these things are on one person. You know, in a family you have two, see you? The Bible says two is better than what? Better than one. But yet, you're here, one person, and the whole world expects you to come out with that best grade so that you can pressure the future of tomorrow, anyway. Yeah? So what do we do? What do we do? We are still the same person. But anyway, because we live in a fallen world, because we live in a planet that is corrupted by sin. You know, that which was good has now been made evil. You know, we come here, we are students, you know, we are medical students, and we are doing all our best because we feel that when we are out there, we are going to change the world. You know, that's why we come to school, so that when we go out there, we can do what? Change the world. You know, but how many times do people leave from these institutions and go out there and do a disaster to the world rather than change the world? That which was made, that which was good, has been made evil instead of doing that. You know, before, there used to be something called the School of the Prophets. We know those ones? Yes. Those that were first brought out by Samuel, Prophet Samuel. And in these institutions, they used to learn Hebrew, they used to learn music, they used to learn sacred history, they used to learn all these beautiful things. Just me. You Hebrew only wanna so is the one that we should be studying in school. But man, it is hard. Pastors, trouble to study those things. Yet it is good. You know, our minds have been we have accepted, we have lived and molded, and our big brains that used to be kitambo are now very narrow. That these things become very technical to us, and they become even more harder for us to understand in these current times. But yet, I was reading somewhere a book called E.M. Bounds of Prayer. And then I realized something. Listen to this. The author says, trouble is God's servant to do his will. It is one of God's most efficient agents to fulfill his purposes and perfect his what? His saints. The trouble is what? God's what? God's servant. To fulfill what? His purposes. As hard as it is to accept and to embrace, God's hand yet is still on every of the troubles and every of the trials that you have faced in this institution, or you faced when you were here before, or those that you're facing right now, even as an associate from this place. God's hand is on every trouble that breaks into the lines of people's lives. Not that he directly
or arbitrarily orders every unpleasant experience in our life. But he allows these things to come so that he will shape and fashion a particular character in what? In you and in me. As you live in that hostel, as you lived, you can attest to it, that once you are living here alone, you are able to learn to manage your bills. And then you have to sleep hungry, you will know next time not to go and do shopping with all the rest of your friends and come back home and you are there, you are alone. You will know next time how to do what? To deal and to handle your expenses, misery. So that is why he says, James chapter 1 and verses 2. James chapter 1 and verses 2. He says this to the saints. He says this, my brethren, count it all joy when you face, when you fall into various what? Temptations. Count it all joy. Now let us narrow down into this verse. He says, count it all joy. He's not forcing you to say that it is all happy, all good, that you're facing what? Trials and temptations in this place. Or you even faced any of those. He says, count it, consider it good that you're going through whatever you're going through. Because the Lord, he continues to say that knowing this, that he, that he tries of your faith works what? Patience. It works patience. It works perseverance. It works a certain character in you. And the associates here can attest to that. Similar. That which you learned from this place, it is what is holding you out there. That which you learned in the coaster. Yes. That which you learned in the coaster is what is holding you out there. That is why they can come back here and join in the associate Sabbath. Because they have, the associates have something special in this place. That they can say that for sure, this is what I learned from this place. You know, we cannot control the circumstances. We cannot control circumstances. We cannot control how these things happen. We cannot help but control how they come and how they go. We don't know what is coming to us for the next time. But we can control how we think about them. The Bible says, consider it what? Joy. I was considering that the book, the word joy in Greek is the word chara. And if you understand the man, the meaning of the word chara is joy, happiness, but I learned one very nice definition to us. It's an attitude. Attitude of what? Happiness. Joy is an attitude. So all that you have experienced from this place, will you leave this place saying that yes, this place has been a disaster, you have gone through all the worst experiences. Maybe there are those who have come from this place having their lives lost even for the worst. But yet, when you stand from out there, still look at this place and say, yes, I went through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but I can look and say that God is good through it all. Count it all joy when you go through adverse and various temptations, because the testing of your faith will bring about what? Perseverance. It will bring about patience, and it will grow a character. And then he continues to say, but let patience have her perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, lacking in what? Nothing. That from this place you'll have a complete, a mature character that can stand the test of time, even out there. Now here we are confined. We are confined in these buildings. You know that if you do this, if you dress wrongly, if you eat badly, if I say something, my elder, church elder, kokaribu hapa, I know that one is a deacon, kokaribu pale, I may not do it, I may not go scot-free from the church board. But when you're out there, nobody is looking at you, then there is character, that is where character is presented again. But once you have learned from this place, then when you go out there, you're able to also contain yourself in the midst of the world. You know, you may go, you may have gone through the troubles until, you know, personally, I sit down, I look at all that I've gone through, and the only song that comes to my mind is this one.
My troubles are many, and my pleasures are few. I guess life is always that way, but I can't complain, 'cause I know I'll be free when I get to heaven someday.
Do you know that song? Yes, it came on my soul in a second. That when I get to heaven someday, I shall be done from the troubles in this place. I shall go to that place as an overcomer. One who has gone through the trials and the troubles of this, because Jesus is coming in this generation. He's not coming in the next generation. In this very generation. We are not expecting him in another. I don't think when I look around, I don't think there's anything else that Jesus is waiting for. He's coming in this very generation. I don't think we are going to wait for more 50 more years. I don't know where we will be 50 years from now. But I want to know, we will be able to stand and say, like the psalmist in Psalm chapter 44 and verse 3. He says that horses prepare for the battle. Horses prepare for the battle. People prepare for the battle. People take time to look for the battle. But victory belongs to Jesus. You have struggled through your troubles that you have gone through in this place. No wonder he says, that is why you are a worthy candidate to be in this place. This is a reunion Sabbath. Through the troubles that you went through, that is why you can attest and stand firm and say that, yes, I am an associate, proud associate of where? Of the Costa. Because I was able to overcome, I was able to go through all the trials and issues that come by being a student in this place, and I have overcome them, and now I can stand with the rest of others and say, I am a graduate of this place. And that will be our experience when Jesus comes. That while we have gone through the trials and the issues and sin that has put us down, he always has to make us feel that we are worthless and useless. That is the work of the devil. Every day, pulling us back. Every day, making and ensuring that you feel so useless. You try out things. As a student, the first time I was in a university, the first friends that I found a very close person. She was called by my name, Ida Kemonto. And we were doing the same course, but she was a year ahead of me. And the first thing that this person tells me is that, I think the second week when I was in that institution, so she finds me out and she's like, hey, Ida, come I tell you some few things. And we go to her house, she presents to me some food, and I was so happy that I found a namesake, I found a housemate, and she's like, yeah, there are shortcuts in this institution. You don't have to go the long way. You know? Yeah, you don't have to go the long way. You can be friend. I can give you a number of one of the professors that will be your friend, so that in times akikupigia simu, you can meet up with them. And one of the hotels along Thika Road, so that you can do whatever you do from there. And next time you're requesting for a grade, which is given to you, like, and I'm like, good Lord, I'm just but a fresher. What are you exactly telling me? How will I survive? And I was so troubled, but yet I ran away from that. The Bible says that flee from the devil. Yes, do not walk, do not crawl, but run away at a supersonic speed. That is the only fastest we know. You fly. Yeah? Fly from the devil. You have gone through such experiences. You have gone through such experiences. And Jesus, that is his desire. He says in Revelation chapter 7, verse 14. Revelation chapter 7 and verse 14. Because such are the people that he is even coming for. I can imagine that reunion when he says in verses 14, these are they who have come out of the world out of this great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Those who have overcome, those are the ones that Jesus is coming for. Those are the ones that Jesus is preparing those mansions in heaven for. I can imagine when Jesus comes. You know, this one is a great reunion. When the associates come and, you know, they're hugging, they're like, hey, high five, and you're high-fiving everyone, and you're like, yeah, I remember you, your class 2015, your class 2020, class 2021, and you are so happy to meet with your friends. You can imagine the reunion that you're going to have with Jesus. Yeah. I don't know how that is. I don't know, evening, it will be a bright, glorious morning. I can see in the eastern horizon, in the blue skies, a cloud large as the fist, the hand of a man, half the hand of a man. It is coming slowly. It is coming slowly. And the saints are waiting, those who have not overcome. So do not let your issues here pull you down and you lose hope in Jesus. So if this cloud is coming, let us get into heaven together. So the cloud is coming. It is coming. On the cloud, just around it, is a rainbow. Under it is fire. All around it are tens and thousands of angels. And on it is Jesus Christ. On top of his head are many crowns. On his right hand is a sickle to bring down the harvest of those who stood fast. On the other hand is a trumpet, a silver trumpet, that as it's coming down, as the cloud is coming down to receive people, then Jesus sounds the trumpet loud and clear. And then he waves his hand and tells those who are in the grave, awake, awake those who are in the ground, and raise up to come and join up with me. And I can imagine the earth, it is shaking, it is trembling, and those that were dead in Christ do what? They rise to life. And that body that was immortal, that was mortal, it is putting on immortality. And the body that was corrupt is putting what? Incorruption. And we are able to see and meet up with our friends. We are now able to meet up with our friends, our parents, those that we lost. Our children, those that we will not embrace. We can see our loved ones, our best friends, those that we left. You know, that is what we are going to call the great ultimate reunion. Amen. I will think of, for me, I'll be going everywhere. You know, at that time, you see, the Bible says that we will be caught up together with them. As soon as they come out, they are going up, and that day, we have to defy gravity. We have to defy gravity. We are going to raise up from our crowns, and we are going up. We are going up. I, with my friends, those that I love so much, and we are going up. We are going up, and we enter into that cloud with Jesus. And we are going up. And then as we are going up, my friends, as we are going up, Jesus is there. It's like, wait, my dears. You have not yet. You just put on that cloth, that body of immortality. But yet, I have a crown for you. I have a beautiful crown for you. And then Jesus himself takes the crowns, and he goes and he puts it on my head. And it's like, yes, you deserve it. And on top of my crown, he says that in heaven, there will be no starless what? There will be no starless crown. And as I look upon my crown, I'm like, yes, this crown. Yes, this crown. Every star to every soul that I was able to reach out to. I can imagine seeing brother, Father Abraham. Father Abraham, how many crowns, how many stars will he be having on his head? And imagine, with all the testimony and the life of faith that he lived, and how many he has been able to transform in our life right now. I can see Brother Simon Peter. You remember him? Yes. Despite his waywardness, while Jesus was here, he was able to be transformed, and he began a ministry that right now we can attest that the life of Simon Peter is a testimony to us right now. Amen. I can see Sister Mary Magdalene. Her life, though it was Yaribiwa now, one among the Pharisees themselves, but yet her faithfulness until the end, and even after Jesus' ascension, we can see her life that has embraced and brought us again to him. I can see Uncle Paul. Yes. I can see Uncle Paul and his crown on the head and how many millions of stars going up his head. And Ellen G. White says that we will, you know, other crowns will be having lots and lots of stars on them, but all of us will be satisfied perfectly. But then I have overcome. Yes, I went through the Matthew University, but despite it all, I have overcome.
Amen.
And Jesus is there with us. He's gladly saying that, yes, my children, take that crown. He puts it on each of us himself. He dresses us with a white robe and gives unto each of us a new name. A new what? A new name. Because some of us are not weird names, right? Very weird names. You cannot even mention them in public. But that day, Jesus gives each of us a new name. And the new name is put upon your crown. And you are there, beautiful. I think we are being everywhere. I'm looking at every star, every universe. I think for the first thing I'm going to look for is Venus, not this morning star, yeah? I'll be going, holding my friends, let's go and check out Venus, let's go and check out Pluto. And you know, that thing that we used to see, and we are going everywhere and everywhere. Jesus is like, hey guys, please come by. We are now entering into that city. And now as we are going, we're seeing the glorious city, and Jesus himself is holding the gates of that city by his hand, and he slams it open, and then it is dazzling in beauty, and we are seeing the new Jerusalem.
Amen.
I don't know if you guys are seeing that new Jerusalem. Inside the new Jerusalem, I can see on that holy city God himself, seated on his holy crown, on his holy throne. And right about, I can see around, I can see the mansions that Jesus said that be not troubled, I am with you. I go to prepare what? A mansion for you. That where I am, you may also be. I can see that those houses, they are made of four pillars all around, pillars of pearl. And they're all having a glittering show from us. And from this side, I can see the dazzling beauty. And Jesus is there saying, welcome in. He ushers us in. Into that glorious home. I wonder such a glorious union that it shall be. So friends, my dear, I don't want to get into heaven so much, because you know, there's a big long table where we all will sit with our Jesus. I think Jesus will be on that right side, and next to him, I don't know, maybe you'll find me there, huh? Just next to Jesus. Inspiration says that those who have fought this battle so seriously and won by faith, those highest in faith shall sit next to Jesus himself. So strive with all your heart. Strive that you may be in that place, that you may be on that round. I don't want it to be a round, it will be a long table with Jesus himself. Now this one may not be the reunion that we are expecting. We may not, this is not the ultimate thing, but that shall be ultimate. Amen.
Amen.
That is why we sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Because when we all get to heaven, what a joy it shall be to sit with Jesus himself and tell him the story. Inspiration says that when Ellen White was just inside the city, he sat just next to the tree of life. Now, there was a river that is flowing from the throne of God. A river that is flowing from the throne, very throne of God. And then just to the sides of the river that is flowing, then there's a tree. And then the tree looked like it is separate, but towards the middle, it was joining up. And every of the fruits that was around that tree was 12 different types of fruits. And as they were listening, they were seated down on that tree, they could look on the glories of the land, on the beauties that heaven could even think. You know, the Bible says that the eyes have not seen, ears have not heard what the Lord has prepared for us.
Amen.
I don't know why we struggle in the things of this world. Why do we even care? Why do we even get so worried and so caught up in all these things? And yet there's a beauty that is they sat and looked at the glories of the land, they're like, yes. They tried to remember all the trials, all the struggles. What of them could have been the most hardest that could have stopped them from this place, getting to this place? But they realized not even one could be remembered. None could be compared to the glories of that land. None could be compared to the glories of that land. So, my dear friends, when we all get to heaven, God's a day of rejoicing that to be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. The Lord indeed, He is our peace. He is our refuge at this time. Let's not run to any other person. Souls, but always look up to Jesus, because He only can give us the peace of mind that we so desire in this rightful time. He promises us a mansion in heaven. So as you go through your trials, as you go through your issues in this life, always remember there's a beautiful crown that is waiting for you. There's a beautiful robe that He only shall put upon you. There's a beautiful name that Jesus shall put upon you. And that shall be yours and yours to stay. There's a mansion that you cannot imagine how inside. They say that inside it are many gifts that we would have possessed when we were here. But we were so busy, we were so troubled that we did not ask of them. So we are going to receive all of them in that glorious place. And Jesus Himself shall be our Father, and He with us in that glorious place. I do not know how many people desire with me that this reunion may not just be in this place, but also I'll be in that ultimate reunion with Jesus Christ Himself. Amen. Amen. Here rise and let us sing in that song. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing His mercy and His grace in the mansion.
What a day of rejoicing that will be.
had trials, we have had temptations, we have had troubles in this faith. Yet we say we are Adventists, yet we say we are Christians. But many a times these burdens, they weigh us down. And we look ahead, we see no future for us. When we look back, we cannot understand where we're coming from. And those who are around us just don't seem to make any sense, or even have an idea of what the future will hold for us. We have come gloriously from this place yet as associates. Yes, we are grateful, we are happy for the days that we were able to spend in this place. But yet again, troubles and trials come and cloud our situation, come and cloud our minds, and we worry so much. But in this day, we have said that yet we have met with our friends in this place. We have been reunited with those that who are friends, but yet are still alive. But we cannot wait for that glorious union, where we shall be friends, we shall meet again with our beloved, those who died ahead of us, those who are even more Christian than we are right now, those whom we loved the most, those whom we cherished the most. Lord, we are looking forward to that day that we shall not, we will be able to meet those friends, but more so, we shall meet with you, our Redeemer, with you, our brother, with you, our friend, who has won all these battles for us, who comes into our lives and tells us, peace be still, when it is so stormy, when it's so tempestuous. I pray, dear Lord, that you may put that joy in our hearts, that as we leave this place, we may have our hopes renewed, we may have our joys increased, because we have a hope in Jesus Christ. You, O Lord, have promised us this glorious heaven. Put it in our hearts, that we may not let the troubles and trials weigh us down, and we will forget the way towards heaven. So give us this hope, given us the trust in our hearts that we may believe in you even when it do not make sense. Hold us by the hand and walk with us, that we may walk and enter into that narrow gate. We may walk into that street that is made of pure gold. With you, Jesus, on our head, we will fear no evil. Keep us in your wings. Keep us under your shelter this day and forevermore, and bless us in this Sabbath day, and help us to enjoy in your presence, because you have promised to be with us from the beginning to the end, because it is our prayer, it is our hope, it is our trust, now and forevermore. We pray and trust, and in the whole church say,
Amen.
God bless you, God keep you, in Jesus' name.